Saturday fun day over here at 12th State Off-Road this weekend. Show you what's going on.
Got Jill's mini truck in, cut the sliders off. Trey did this week, so today we are going to weld them back on. They were sitting in a little bit too far. We designed them and put them on before I solid axle swapped her mini truck. Trey's buggy. He is in the middle of working on it right now. And then another buddy of ours is getting worked on, getting the whole front bumper redone on it. Next project in the shop for 12th State here. They've got Jill's mini truck done. I got it loaded on the trailer. They're redoing his front bumper. He had that plate bumper. They're going to do a hoop bumper for him out of tube. And then they're going to do some rub rails on the quarter right here that pass in through to the inner cage.
Bless America. What do you just hit it hard?
You want lots of speed, not much pressure.
Oh.
Spot.
All right, so it's now Monday morning. Open up the shop like usual, waiting for everybody else to get here. So we got going on today. Nothing's changed on it. You guys saw I went to 12th State this weekend, so I didn't come up here and do anything. This is kind of the spare project, not really concentrating my full time on it, especially today. We've got way too much other stuff done, but all the parts came in. We're gonna throw a starter on it anyways. Intake manifold gasket, valve cover gasket. Gonna ahead and do a time and bolt water pump kit, even though I was told it was done. Just peace of mind, spark plugs, the whole quick tune-up thing. So it's the next day. It is now Tuesday. Didn't video anything yesterday. Just got caught in the working on this thing and getting stuff done. So here's what I got done yesterday. We'll try videoing more today.
I got the timing belt and water pump done on this, as well as the serpentine belt. Got the intake manifold off, got a new starter put into it. Today's task are the valve covers. As you can see, this one's quite leaky. So we'll do them both because this one's seeping a little bit too, might as well. Intake manifold, got it off, cleaned up, got it painted, because why not? Why it sat here while I was over here working on other things. Mini truck here, finally got my fuel cell in the back and got rid of those two jerry cans I had going on. Made a really cool, you know, cooler holder, tool bag holder, dipple dyed it, because why not? So it's gonna get taken to the house and get out of the shop. 100 series got diagnosed yesterday, Nissan Titan lift. It is done, getting ready to get alignment. This 200 series right here, I just got done swapping in some 6,000K headlight bulbs for it, so it's a little bit better lighting than what comes stock on them. And we're getting ready to start knocking out interior lights.
That's the day. What's going on, everybody? So it is now Wednesday morning. All week, I've pretty much been knocking out small little jobs, just stuff here and there on this thing. Done the time belt, the water pump, serpentine belt, starter, valve cover gaskets, intake manifold gaskets, cleaned out the throttle body, changed a few hoses and stuff here and there that were cracked, and just generally just maintenance on it, spark plugs, kind of the boring stuff. I've taken some videos and did some time lapse of me doing the timing belt. Just not entertaining. So let me show you what I got going on. Real quick, today though, I've got to rebuild that rear end right there for a buddy of mine. We're going wheeling in 2 weekends from now. And I also got a shipment in of transfer cases. So I bought 3 FJ Cruiser transfer cases. I only need one, but nice to have a backup. The weak link in the system is probably after the axles. Is gonna be that chain driven transfer case. So it'd be nice to have another one just laying in the corner just in case. Might use them for another project, who knows. Local junkyard had a deal on them, so couldn't pass them up. So we'll show what we got going on with the front end of this thing. All right, like I said, time belt water pump, that's all hidden behind there. New serpentine belt. Took the intake manifold gasket out intake manifold off so we could change the starter out. It's way down in there. While it was off, painted it because it was all corroded aluminum. New gaskets for it. Valve cover gaskets got changed. And then painted them red while they're off because why not? Other than that, the only real things that have changed on this thing is the new oxygen sensor, that one that was all tore up. It was on there. Sourced a exhaust piece because that muffler is going away so we can hear this V8 roar. And other than that, oh, these came in. Yeah. That's gonna be killer. KMC true beadlocks. Negative 38 offset. Toyota 6 lug, 17, I believe, by 9.5. Let's see what it says by 9, sorry. It's upside down, but you get the point. Yeah, so those are gonna look killer on this thing. Waiting on tires. Got the tires ordered. They're 5 to 6 weeks, which sucks. But 39, 1350, 17, BFG, KM3s. And I know you're asking, why didn't you go red labels or blue labels crawlers? Well, blue label crawlers only go up to 37s. I've already got a truck on 37, so let's go bigger. The red labels, while it would be cool to have red labels on this thing, my goal, because we can, is to have this thing street legal. And I don't want to ride around on red labels just because I will wear them out so fast. KM3s are exceptionally made wheel tires. Talking to the BFG rep, the same engineers that worked on the crawlers are the same ones that did the KM3s. The material compound is super close. Here on the East Coast, more, we'll call it mud. Not really mud, but mud, moisture. So the KM3s are probably fit the bill better. Not gonna daily drive this thing, but it would be nice to be able to ride it around town, take the kids to school, just have fun with the thing. So the KM3 is gonna fit the bill. Plus they're gonna be 39s, KM3s. They're nothing wrong with them. Yeah. If we start getting super hard into wheeling and we have to go buy a second set, we will, but yeah, we should be good with KM3s. I've got them on my 5th-gen 4Runner. They're awesome. This thing's gonna be even better. Plus the price was a big factor in that as well, and availability. Red labels are kinda hard to come by. KM3s, like 5 to 6 week wait time right now, and that's just only right now. Usually there's someone that has one or two in stock, so we'll be good there. But yeah, let me throw some more pictures up of this thing. Today's plan is to get the wiring, start with this mess of wiring, get it started to get cleaned up, mess with it a little bit yesterday, but just kind of getting a game plan of what we can go ahead and cut out right away. All the VSC, trash control, ABS, all those computers are going away. Pretty much gonna dwindle it down so it's just the engine ECU and the immobilizer, because plan on having the key for this thing. Like I said, we'll drive it and park it in parking lots, and I'd like to have a key and not just have two very well labeled switches that say ignition and start and then no steering lock. So yeah. Yeah, still waiting on the reduction box to get here. So I did get seats, picked up some Corbo Baja XPs from Facebook Marketplace. Trey, aka Sweet Brown, aka 12 State Off Road, they popped up near his house. He picked them up for me, then I picked them up from him. Walk over here where they are. They're up top on the shelf way up there because they're box one and then the other one's in a bag. Yeah, super comfortable seats. They're suspension seats, super thick cushion on them. They're honestly more comfortable than any vehicle stock seat I've ever sat in. So those are gonna be nice, but gotta get that wiring cleaned up first today. So, all right guys, let me set you a little time lapse here. I'll tear apart this rear end, put it back together, and then we'll start working on a 4th-gen 4Runner crawler. Sections are tore apart on this thing. A little bit of gear there, but he caught it early enough to where the pinion just got one little mark right there, and that's it. Obviously, we're gonna change it all out, but it wasn't completely destroyed. Just like that, diff is done. Fast forward about an hour and a half. So now, we do some electrical. So, it runs. We start taking stuff off. massively long time lapse was about 2.5, maybe 3 hours of just clipping wires, terminating them, or running them all the way back to the nearest plug, cutting at the plug or at the ECU. Let me show you what I got going on.
We got this entire mess of wires right here eliminated so far. So right now we are down to ground block, the plug that goes to the firewall, a junction box, and the main ECU. All of the other stuff, even got the ECU immobilizer, it working. Eliminated the factory alarm, or the aftermarket alarm, I should say. So all that is way simplified. We have worked our way all the way over. I'm now eliminating the HVAC. So this was HVAC, blower, something else HVAC related. So what we're doing is peeling the wires apart, cutting into the harness, figuring out where they go. So obviously that big white with black, generally on all Toyotas, white wire with black stripe is a ground, so that goes up to this ground block to the chassis, so we can, that'd be an easy one. All these little pink ones go up to the computer here for the HVAC system, so most of that will go away here in a minute. And then these wires right here, instead of digging into the full harness, we'll just terminate them right here with some shrink wrap, tape them up. They have no power going to them anyways because we pulled all the fuses and the relays for the HVAC. We're just trying to eliminate clutter here. So yeah, no idea what that goes to, but it's not plugged in, so we'll probably just tape over them.